I didn't want to step on your joke. That was good. Is that the fucking
film at the Avery compound?
Avery pick and pull there. Hey, what's this? How much for this raw of four hood?
Welcome to the Chip and Cern Show, the podcast about everything and nothing at the same time. They were possibly separated at birth, only to be rejoined to create the sweet sounds that will caress your deepest cochlea. The show is real, random, rant-filled, and ruthless. Please be warned that this show may hurt your feelings, offend your grandma, and even kick your dead dog in the balls. So get ready, and let's get this shit started.
This shit has started. I'm Chip.
I'm Cern.
And you were listening to the Chip and Cern Show.
Once again, or for the very first time.
So we were doing it. We did it again, Cerny. We even stopped ourselves twice. So I was inquiring. Here's what happened in the 5 to 10 leading up to the show, which could just be called the pre-show.
Yes.
I had just discovered my PG&E bill was $404 for the last billing cycle. Now, that seemed like a lot of money to me because I'm like, that's sniffing a half a grand a month. I'm like, this is a lot. But I didn't, you know, it's one of those things that I don't pay super attention to, right? It's like, it just kind of happens. But also, it's not like I'm running my house to be 80 degrees in the winter and I'm not, you know, making it. I turn the AC on in the summer, and I run the heater in the winter. We have two young kids.
Like most people.
Yeah, we have two young kids. Everyone's at home all the time, so everything's always...
always going, especially right now. Everything's going.
There's always a laundry going. There's always, you know...
Ears are always going, fired up.
So I was like, Cerny, how much is your... like, give me a, I only have my data point, $400. My gut says that's a little hot. No pun intended. So I need another data point. So I said, Cerny, what's your power bill?
So including, because I have the solar, which is under the power purchase agreement, which is basically solar panels collect a certain amount of kilowatts. And it varies. In the winter, obviously, it's less than in the summer.
Right.
But then they basically, you get charged, you know, mine's like 10 cents a kilowatt to run so it's at that cost for up to whenever they use it. And then you're on the grid.
Okay. So you get a little bit of recredit almost that you're just kind of eating it. Have you ever had any months where you haven't had to hit the grid?
No. I mean, they,
your house is too big.
Worked it down to a science. Yeah. Oh, there's
you had a one bedroom
animals,
apartment.
All sorts of shit. Yeah,
there's a lot of beings at Cerny's house. A lot of things with a heartbeat over there.
Yes,
a lot of heartbeats over there at the Cerny residence. So
this,
yeah,
I did it. I did this also because, also, kind of, it's almost like buying futures because the prices of energy goes up, so I kind of basically locked in.
I sell short, Cerny, every time. I'm selling short. I'm actually shorting AMC right now. I'm hurting in a bad way.
GameStop,
yeah. Sorry. You're in the future. There's technology that's going to be available that Cerny can store that power on the side, like a power bank wall kind of thing.
Ooh, the Tesla battery.
The Tesla battery,
multiple times.
You know, as the panel's technology increases and instead of them only being able to capture X amount per hour or whatever, it's going to be 10 times that. And Cerny's already got the infrastructure set up for it.
Yes, yes. So, you know, but yeah, 400 is pretty, pretty tough.
Now, I know the house I grew up in, I did things a little differently in my life with my family than the house I grew up in, meaning running the air conditioning in the summer and running the heater in the winter. Because if I had a guess, ballpark, certainly you've been to my house a couple of times and we in our youth, what would you say?
Spring and fall were the ideal times to visit Chip's house.
You don't want any of those, two severe months, the summer and the winter.
Yeah.
Because basically it was like you would just get told go open a window or go out, like go somewhere, go run in front of the sprinklers or whatever. Or in the winter, beanie, hoodie, sweats, slippers.
In the summer, undies.
Undies. We just had a pile of laundry on our front porch, and it was just all of our friends. They would all just get down to their undies when they would come inside because it was so fucking hot. But anyway. Well, Cerny.
One second. I actually had a thing. So a while back, so we have SMUD as our Sacramento Municipal Utility, whatever.
Depot or some shit.
Whatever it is, department or division or who knows. They do run our electricity, which is, they're actually pretty good. They're pretty fair. They, you know,
PG&E is known for being pieces of shit.
Shysters. So they run our gas.
Okay.
So one.
I'm not 100% sure. That's your hot water heater and maybe your stove or something, right?
Yes. Yes. And the furnace, it says gas too.
Okay.
But we have a furnace up, up in the attic.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So it was always like $40 or something like a month gas, because gas isn't really. And then one time it was like $300, like just 1 month, just randomly. I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
So I sent something to them going, hey, what the fuck is this? And they're are you running your heater? I'm like, yeah, but nothing out of the ordinary. They're like, well, we recommend that you keep your house at 55 degrees. I said, fuck you. Fuck
55?
You. I think I wrote back, fuck you. It's not a meat locker. I'm not owning here. 55. Yeah, thanks. And I said, and I found out, I did some research, and it was like people were going, it was like something had happened, because people were saying, hey, I've always paid like $50 a month, and now you're like a $5,000 bill, $500 bill. What's going on? You know?
There was a leak.
Yeah.
Or malfunction somewhere.
And they said, no. But then all of a sudden, next billing cycle is miraculously back to.
Oh, it's all straightened out.
Yeah.
It was a clear, just a clear.
I love the recommendation. 55. I was like, what?
First of all, you know that motherfucker doesn't have their house at fucking 55 degrees.
Like 55.
I couldn't even. I don't even know if it could get. If
you
your house
in the
could
ocean
get
at 55, you get hypothermia. Why would I live in that?
I don't even know if I can get my house to 55 during the winter. I mean, if it was 30 outside and you opened everything up.
The windows, yeah.
Yeah. But I. Yeah.
We call it the polar bear club by house, asshole.
I mean, it's not like we're in Minnesota, you know. Like, what's their power bill? Maybe it's cheaper. Who knows?
Maybe they have, like, they're rolled by the fire or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
I saw this thing.
Shoveling coal and
people, shit. People know, people from California, because they say the snow, like it's a fucking place and not a thing.
Like, because really, though, when you were kids, it's like, hey, we're going to go to the snow.
Yeah. Like it was an event.
I'm reinforcing that with my kids right now. I'm like, we could go to the snow. Like, the snow? Could we throw snowballs? I'm like, yeah. Could we build a snowman? I'm like, yeah. Could we do a snow? I'm like, you could do it all at the snow.
So I think like Jeffrey was like 5 the first time we saw snow, because we were in the drought for the first, you know.
Oh, right.
So here's his life. So it never fucking snowed, or at least not enough to stick.
Yeah.
Remember now, it was like February, it'd be like, just grass. Like, holy shit.
Looks like, yeah, like a summer baseball field, but it's February. It's
Field
3rd.
Of dreams.
Yeah. That's pretty funny. Well, Cerny, did you get in on any AMC?
Okay,
any
GameStop? So about a year or so ago, I bought the boys GameStop at $4 a share.
Because you're like, for less than $20.
Yeah. It was like, they wanted to do something or whatever. I had probably like, they probably had like 6 shares, 7 shares, maybe 10 shares.
Okay.
It was like, this ain't worth shit, you know, whatever it was. So it's like, just dump it and move it to somewhere else, because it went up to like from 4 to 5. And I saw the thing. I was like, this is about as good as it gets, everybody. So I was like, all right, you know what? Let's just move it to, I forget what it was. It was actually an energy company. And then when I saw the AMC thing, I was like, what the hell? And I was like, GameStop, it was like $360 a share. I was like, God damn it.
Oh my God. So good. Well, Cerny, it's today it dropped 30%, but it's still at 225.
Yeah, at the height it was like 367 or something, I think.
469.
Off.
Nice. Nice.
Cool. 4G's just out the door.
Damn, this thing looks like the coronavirus graph. Like when they
are we past
know,
the
yeah, we think we're in phase one. Oh no. Look at this thing, Cerny. Look at the 5 year, look at the 5 year on this. Or the here's the 50, here's the whoa, it's like
yeah,
fucking
see, I was over there in the $4 range.
Wow, 401.
Yep. Yep, that's where I was sitting. I think it went up to 5. I was like, okay. Boys, we made it.
Because dude, the 52 week low was 250.
Yeah, it was like they say basically it wasn't worth anything.
So I don't know. So this CEO, he's got to be like, did he become like a billionaire somehow? Because if they were giving him all this stock when it was like $4, they're like, here's millions of shares. We don't care. And now it's worth 200. Now he's like a billionaire all of a sudden.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
I was just like, oh, of course, of all the stocks.
Of course. Did you see it must have been what fake tweet, but it was like Blockbuster was like, yo, do your thing over here.
Oh yeah, I did see that. Yeah. Work your magic or some shit.
Yeah, something like that. That's pretty funny. This is one of those things that everyone knows about. It kind of has the same hotness as like Bitcoin did when that kind of spiked up and everyone's going fucking nuts. About that. Oh. And Joe and Dana hot on the Bitcoin. Are they holding still? No fucking chance they're holding right now, right? On Bitcoin?
No, probably. I wouldn't get. Maybe, I mean, if they did, it's probably, you know, locked away with the David Jones locker. Never found again.
Yeah. So, oh man. And I think Dana and Joe got in on the GameStop, right?
I think so. I know the AMC at least. I don't know about GameStop.
Oh no, it's down another 15% after hours. People are like, here comes the sell, Cerny. So the like overly simplistic thing of this, and we're not like, you know, fucking stock professionals, but you basically you're essentially gambling. You're buying a share that you don't actually own.
And on a short sell?
Yeah, on a short sell, and then at some point, you actually have to buy that piece of stock that you committed to, but it was at a certain dollar amount, right?
Yeah, so it's like, do you listen to Planet Money?
No.
So they explained it pretty well. It's like if I had,
well,
like,
then we go check out Planet Money then.
Yeah, there you go.
We will try it, but Cerny, what? Give us.
It's basically like if nuts were like $10 a bushel or whatever, or $10 a pound. You take a loan out for that and you sell it for $10 a pound and then you wait for it to crash and then you buy it back from that person and give your loan back basically and you pocket the money.
Oh. So basically all these kind of hedge funds had over indexed on counting GameStop to basically go bankrupt. Belly up.
I think it was over because it was like, I was surprised when it was like 60, when they said it was like $60 a share. I was like,
yeah. Now, you know, if you have 5 shares and your short sell amount was $5 and it's up to 60, damn, that's a fucking hit. But these mutual funds have millions of shares.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
my measly 10 shares.
Yeah.
You miss out on it. Like,
good thing you weren't shorting that. So at some point, they have to pay the difference between what they said they were going to buy it at and the actual price.
Yes.
So if you bought it at like, you know, 250 and it's trading at 225, quite a quite a delta there that you have to pay out of pocket to get that same.
Yeah, if you have a bunch of shares. Yeah.
Yeah. So you're hurting. You're hurting on that one. And, the billionaires are getting kind of upset because.
That's what pisses me off the most. First off, take the mic away from them. Shut the fuck up. No one wants to listen to you cry about the money.
Was it that old dude?
I don't know.
Yeah.
He said it was bullshit. I forget his fucking. I didn't even want to commit his name to memory.
Yeah, he wasn't even worth dedicating. Yeah, the mind power to.
I just know Bernie told him to cry me a river or some shit.
Nice. Feeling the burn, baby. Atta boy, Bernie. Basically, this is what mutual funds and what these billionaires and millionaires do all the time. They're constantly betting against shares to lose. So it's part of the game, but it's like you're essentially betting on someone to lose. And whenever they lose, you're capitalizing on people losing.
Yeah, losing jobs, homes, you know, all that.
Yeah. But the people that lose aren't the billionaires with their money. It's people's actual livelihoods and lives and shit. You know, if GameStop goes out of business, how many fucking pubescent teens, where are they going to work? Where are all these kids going to work? Target, I guess, now? Walmart?
You know what? I actually, this is probably pre-COVID. I went in there because one of the kids is having a problem with the Xbox, and I had to ask him. I was like, fuck.
Oh shit! You
Googled it. And I, like,
you
and
tapped out, Cerny.
I had Googled. I couldn't fucking figure out. Save my life. What it made me feel better. The guy didn't know either. So,
phew.
I was like, fuck! I'm going boomer in this fucking place, and I'm gonna ask him about this.
Like
Xbox.
When someone you always see if you ever walk in the mall, whenever that happens again, you know, and there's an Apple store in there, you always see some dude with his big fucking computer, like carrying his huge ass computer, walking around and shit.
The whole thing.
Look, like he's got his fucking mouse is like hooked in, it's like dangling still, and his keyboard and shit.
He brings a monitor too.
He's got his satellite speakers. He's got a speaker set up. He brought his whole fucking system.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. Now,
Zach's trying to build a computer at the moment.
Oh, buy a case.
Yeah, I mean, we had to get past the bridge of, like, he had the monitor, so he thought he had a PC. I was like, well, what's running that thing? He's like, what do you mean? I was like,
just go to the wall and go, shuts down. It ain't running itself.
Well, I was like, what? No, but it's like, there's nothing. He thought it was like an all-in-one, you know, thing.
Oh, like
you know,
an iMac, like, or something. Or like a laptop, like, basically. He thought it was a laptop or an iPad. Yeah.
Basically a computer, TV screen you got to plug something into. It was hard for him to breathe. I said, there's no brains to this thing.
Dude, this is something that I don't think our kids are going to even really know, unless you're into gaming, what like a computer system is, like you're saying. Because they only know iPads. So the screen and everything's right there. Like the iPad doesn't have a huge fucking tower box to make it go.
I kept saying, are you looking for a tower? No, I want a PC. Yeah, we've established that. I get it.
Wow.
Are you gonna have a computer component? Well, yeah, it's this, and he's pointing at the monitor. Like, no, it's a monitor. And like it was like this whole like who's on first. Like, it was fucking.
Yeah, I'm getting that. Wow.
I was like, but you know, like,
were you boiling?
I'm getting super frustrated. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
And then like you know you get the like, why are you getting so mad? It's like, and I always explain like, you know, when you're explaining something to somebody and they don't get it. And you keep explaining things, and they just sit there and stare at you, and you start getting really frustrated. She says, yeah, that's how I fucking feel. We're talking about, like, you're trying to, first off, A, we're trying to build a computer, and we're calling our monitor a fucking computer.
Because, like, all the Twitch streamers have that, and that's just a cool thing to do, is build a computer,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, okay. And it was like, you know, like I found one, like, oh, you could do this, but he wants the ones with, like, the neon lights, with the fucking plexiglass side.
Oh,
like, I was like,
sure.
You're going to put your fucking tower on your... on your desk?
Dude, you won't be able to sleep at night. It'll be like fucking... Like Mirror Kramer when he lived next to the chicken, the chicken shop.
I said, what are we doing? I said, you're going to put the tower on your desk? I mean, how much space do you have?
How much is it to like build a computer? A couple $100?
Yeah, times, you know, probably closer to like 800 if you want to like a legit one.
Get a good one. Is it cheaper than for a same spec computer, is it cheaper than just going to Best Buy and buying the HP version with the same
specs? I think so.
Yeah.
I'd have to like really dig into it.
But it's not that it's not like it's way more expensive or anything. It's probably, you're probably getting the parts cheaper.
Yeah, it's think. Like you yeah. get like, you know, this motherboard, then you get this, you know, you get a whole bunch of shit.
And then do they just plug in? Is it hard to do? You don't have to do soldering and shit, do you?
No, I don't think so. I think it just snaps together like the motherboard and stuff. I mean, we haven't gotten that far.
So it's like adult Legos. Yeah, adult Legos, kind
of. Hopefully it's not extra pieces at the end.
Yeah. Huh, what's all this RAM doing here? Lagging like fuck, man. Oh, man, that's the thing. Now, Cerny, we meant to do this, and I have noticed on YouTube there's tons of videos. Like, their whole channel is just, like, two white dudes reacting to music that they've never heard before. And I was like, we were doing this before as a fucking thing.
Yeah, I know. We were, you know, I was just, it was this weekend. I was complaining because Jeffrey had, like, was just had YouTube going.
Just auto, just, auto
it's
just play.
These it's these clowns. His name's Preston or something.
I don't even want to.
And, like, they're so successful at doing nothing. He has his own warehouse full of bullshit that they just go run around and fuck around all day.
Sorry.
I was hating on it. And my wife's like, well, you're just jealous. I'm like, goddamn right. Chip and I can go horse around for a couple hours and make
they just
of
fuck
bucks.
Around, right?
Yeah, they're playing hide and seek. What the fuck? Why would you want to watch somebody play hide and seek? But
I think it's because they look up to the, it's, you look up to the, you kind of idolize a little bit. They're the, just the movie stars of their generation.
Yeah, yeah.
I think is what it is. Because they don't really care too much about, oh, the fucking Rock, right?
No, I don't think so. I was told football was boring. I was like,
well, I mean,
I said, okay, I get it, but you watch people play hide and seek, so no, I refuse that statement.
Yeah, no one's getting fucking laid out and concussion protocol on hide and seek.
Are you what you sit there and watch somebody play Minecraft? What the fuck is that?
Is paintball a thing still?
I don't know.
I would think
Zach actually went to like an airsoft party once.
Okay.
He was like, yeah, it hurts really bad. I was like, no, it doesn't. Paintball,
an airsoft?
Like, motherfucker.
Yeah, what was he wearing? Like basketball shorts and a t-shirt probably?
I think so. Because I warned him. I was like, you might want to put some long clothes
put
on.
Put a hoodie on.
No,
yeah.
It's too hot. I was like, okay.
Looks like, I mean,
he had like little, tiny little welt marks, but it wasn't even like,
well,
hurt really bad.
I think when they're like having those parties, first of all, how can they, what do you have to wear, goggles or a mask or something? Probably
these goggles or something.
Yeah. Fucking kid get hit in the eye with that. You're sunk, dude. You're getting the fuck suit out of you. There's no way you're coming back from that.
No.
Hey, want to go have a birthday party? Oh, is that where the kid got his fucking eye shot out at? Yeah, that's the place. No, we're cool. Yeah, we're not going to go there.
Pass. Hard pass.
Now, remember, Cerny, when we had paintball, when my brother would invite a couple of his friends over,
Yes. And
then I would invite Cerny, a couple of my friends over. This is like what we were probably
Joe was there, wasn't he?
Joe would come over. We were 16, 17. My brother was like, you know, 15, 14, 15. So anyway, but we would all agree before, because there was the, what is that? What did that control exactly? But remember, you can basically increase the velocity of how fast it
like
shoots
the
paintball. Yeah. It's like you needed a 4mm Allen key. And Cerny and I were like, you know, obviously the bigger kids, we just knew to grab one of those.
Yeah.
So we would all line them up straight. We're like, okay, we're all in the same. And then when they would run away, we would just crank that bitch to 11. And remember when you would shoot that, it would go so fast. It would like curve. It was like some Randy Johnson.
Through the weeds without breaking. Holy fuck. It's always funny when your little brother and stuff like call you out, like, you turn it up, like, bullshit.
Like, what are you talking about? It's like drawing blood and shit. Yeah, that was fun. That was a good time. Well, Cerny, speaking of two white guys reacting to music they've never heard before, I text you this song, just the title and the artiste. And I said, have you ever heard this? And you hadn't.
I
hadn't even I hadn't heard of it either. Olivia Rodrigo and the song simply called Driver's License.
Now, I'd heard of, like, people were saying something about Driver's License, but I hadn't even looked it up. And,
well, I'm like,
then I waited. Once you said something, I was like, okay.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, we got to wait. We got to wait for the show for sure. But we're in the year 2021. These are modern times, right? Why this is the first time we're getting to a song that someone thinks about singing about getting their fucking driver's license? That hasn't happened before?
I don't know. Actually, I don't know songs about driver's license.
I guess there's, you know, 8675309 about getting a phone or something, so. But
it was the A-team phone back then.
Yeah. Okay. Do we want to go with this thing, Cerny? Olivia Rodrigo, driver's license.
Let's do it.
Holy fuck. This thing premiered January 7th, so it hasn't even been out a month.
4.3 million likes.
Yeah, 4.3 million likes. It gets more dislikes, 61,000, than downloads Chip and Cern has ever sniffed. Probably ever will sniff. But coming in, clocking in at 90.5 million views. And it's about
it makes me think like, could we just like crank our own, we'll do a duet on something basic like going to the store or something.
Yeah. Just call it Trader Joe's. It'll just be a song about two white dudes in Trader Joe's. All right. Olivia Rodrigo, driver's license. Now, driver's license is in all lowercase, which I think is the cool thing now, right?
I guess. Okay, we're driving.
Okay, they're driving. Kind of slow. Since last week, just like we always talked about, because you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house.
Okay. But today
okay. This went a different direction than what I was thinking.
Yeah.
So is she really young? She looks like she's under 18. I would.
You shouldn't be driving if you're blurry eyed.
Yeah. Everything I'm insecure about, yet today I drove through the
suburbs. Cause how could I ever love? You gotta focus on the road if you're driving, especially new driver.
Yeah. Her head's not in the right place. She's got her little keys.
Oh man. Your driver's license.
This is a
she good in the Avery yard.
Oh no. Uh-oh. Fucked it up. I didn't want to step on your joke. That was good. Is that the fucking
film at the Avery compound?
Avery pick and pull there. Hey, what's this? How much for this raw forehead?
Lightly used.
Are these blood stains?
No.
No, okay. Rob for what? Okay. So I have to see this Olivia Rodrigo. I was thinking
this was going to be like a pop song, like the.
I was Cerny. Like, honestly,
what was that song that everyone hated? Friday or some shit.
Oh yeah,
that's what I was thinking as we were going, and then when we started going, I was like, oh,
okay. Yeah, and I how old
I'm not
is
hating
this?
It. I'm not hating. She's 17.
She's 17 from Temecula, California. 5'5". Yeah, because Cerny, we totally were judging this song. I thought the same thing. Like, it's going to be this bubblegum fucking pop. Yeah. I got my driver's license. I can't wait to go to the fucking movie theater and shit. Yeah. Like, I was getting ready to climb.
Taco Bell.
Driving near old school. I don't know. I didn't have anything else I was going to. I was either going to take it too vulgar, but then my brain was like, these are, if you just got your driver's license 16, this isn't a good path to continue this joke down. So I fucking pulled the e-brake on it.
Next week's guest, Chris Hansen.
Tripper, let's play a clip we heard from the last 260-something shows.
Is this you? Is this you speaking?
This is you? We have you on video. That's a deep fake, Chris. You know what else I thought? Kids will not have to deal with an e-brake, like pulling the e-brake. Because my cars now don't have an e-brake. They have like a button.
Oh, you're right. You know what? And as these cars get newer and stuff, will they really have to deal with breaking down on the side of the road?
Probably not.
Because, mostly, for last time I heard, they said basically the computer components inside will fail first before the engine ever does, because they said they build them so well now.
Shit.
Remember the Mustang? That fucker was... It was like weekly for a long time.
That was like when that thing would start up, it was a good day. Because it would really struggle during the heat or the cold.
It was the heat, yeah.
Then it was like it would get too hot, and sometimes we had to stop and let it chill for. But if it was sitting in the sun, it was a real problem.
Yep. Then it was just God.
Yeah. Okay. So Cerny, I gotta say, I totally misjudged the song. Yes, I was expecting
a pop thing.
I'm really digging this. It's quite. I wasn't expecting a ballad type, powerful type song.
You know, I like the ballads. That's one of my
November Rain.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we're jumping back into it.
That song about me. You said forever. Now I drive alone past your street.
In Colorado, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
She's poor lighting, though.
It's almost like she's walking through.
Oh my God,
like
she's in the middle of the fucking road.
Dead.
I kind of feel sorry for them, because they'll never know you the way that I do. Yet today I drove through the suburbs and pictured I was driving home to you.
Her eyes are closed. She's driving. Come on now.
This is a great song, and I honestly can't believe someone this young could write something this, like, you know.
Yeah. I like it.
I'm gonna turn it up. Darn.
Give it a like.
4.4 million likes. Done. Okay, you have Olivia Rodrigo. You have two new fans, Chip and Cern. When you're ready for a little bit more exposure, you're welcome. You're welcome on anytime. No problem.
So get your name out there. We'll help you out.
You know what? If we're good for anything, we're good for pumping the numbers. We could pump the numbers a little bit.
Oh, shit.
Wow. That's, I wonder, how do you make money these days as a singer? You can't tour. I guess your streams?
Yeah, maybe like,
or she gets,
I wonder if it's almost like a, you know, YouTube, maybe she gets monetized for the song.
Oh,
and, or,
yeah.
She
probably makes
Spotify
money
and all that stuff and shit.
I wonder if it's still super expensive to shoot a music video anymore. Because everyone, basically your iPhone is like a 4K fucking camera, right? And all your friends have those. And if she's 17 and she's like, I mean, obviously that music video was pro.
Yeah,
that's
pro.
But it wasn't like a $5 million. Anyway, yeah. But I'm rooting for her.
Me too. I liked it. I misjudged that from the start.
Now, I feel like, So that's what all the kids are talking about, is the driver's license. So.
Okay. Hopefully she has more songs come out. Again, we all know. Cern loves the ballad song, so.
He does. Was it a big deal when we got our driver's license? I mean, I remember being excited. But I think I was so hampered with rules and regulations around what the license could actually enable. I was less excited than, say, Cerny.
Yeah, you know, it was also, remember, it was like right when we started driving, when they first came out with that law where you can have like nobody in your car for like,
they really locked it down.
Like that.
And now it's gotten even worse for the kids.
A year or something.
Because, oh, shit, remember? Okay, that was it. So if you have your permit, you could be 15. This is when Cern and I were 15. So 2000 and, 1 or 2002 or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
If you had your permit, you can only, like, I can only drive my brother to school.
Yeah.
or a parent had to be in the car or some shit like that.
Well, then, it's a parent always with a permit.
Oh, right. Okay. But once you hit, once you 16. Got your license, then you could drive with your family. Like, yes. You could take your brother or sister or whatever to school.
Yes.
But then I couldn't give Cerny a ride home.
No, it's like that's your family, like your brother, but like, and then after that, it's like nobody under 25 or some kind of shit like that.
Which, when you're 16, you don't know anyone that's 25.
No, which is 20, a great law. They
yeah. Have, they're like, you know what's a great idea? What if we made a 16-year-old kid know a 25-year-old in order to drive with them? And they all just go, ah! Fuck them. Make it a law. And that's what they do.
Yeah, because you don't know anybody unless, you know. Unless Chris Hansen's tail on your fucking car. Yeah. The predator of the fucking car.
That's true. Now, everyone's parents gave different levels of fucks about this law, this quote-unquote rule or law.
Yes.
Some people's parents were like, don't fucking care, just be safe.
Mm-hmm.
Other people said, oh, if that's the law of the government, the law of the Nicodemus house is actually twice as bad.
Actually, I think my mom made me abide by it. Remember, we used to try to hide shit all the time.
Yeah. Now, remember
like, yeah,
that.
I was like,
yeah. I mean, certain parents are like, okay, if we tell you no, you're probably going to do it anyway. So, might as well just say
if
yes.
If you get busted, then I'll be really mad.
Yeah.
And I'll act like I never knew the whole time.
Totally. Remember that time somehow you were in my car. And then did my mom come up because she needed to pick my brother up or something?
It was like the worst timing because we had left it like early or it was late.
Yeah.
And we're trying to go to a baseball game, I believe.
I think we were probably running late because we were probably dicking around in the locker room fucking with somebody or, yeah. You know, fucking playing grab ass somewhere with somebody. Some fucking tomfoolery was happening and
something.
We were running a little late. And I think at the time, you know, Sir and I weren't really known for our promptness. Just in general, just as 16-year-olds, I think.
Yeah, we horsed around.
Yeah. If there was horsing around to do, whatever was next could just wait for a little bit.
Yeah.
The horsing around was more fun.
I get to math class. Like, yeah, I'll get there. There's some tomfoolery I got to engage in first.
So Cerny was in my front seat illegally in the 1991 Ford Explorer Eddie Bauer edition.
The Shaggin' Wagon.
The Shaggin' Wagon, a.k.a. the locker room. And I said, fuck, there's my mom, get down. And I threw my backpack on top and I, you know, probably fucking laid rubber down and, you know, slipping gears and shit, trying to get out of the fucking parking lot, drawing hella attention to myself, you know, in the process. But I do remember when I got home, who was in your car? What?
Huh?
Me? What are you talking about, mom? Was that Cerny? No, in my backpack. I had my backpack there, and I kind of had my arm on it. She's like, are you lying to me? I'm like, no. Of course.
Take this through.
I'm going to die on a sword for this. I'm taking it to my grave.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
That's and the one thing when, like, kids get older, like, you know, when the roles reversed, where you, like, I've busted. Yeah, busted them, and they're going to die on the sword. I'm like, what the fuck? But then I think back, like, right. Oh, I did the same thing.
Yeah. That's how I've, yeah, I don't know if I'm getting older or whatever, but that's how I'm kind of looking back on stuff too. It's like, okay, hey, I see why, you know, this or that.
Yeah, like I get
situation.
It.
Now, yeah. So now those rules are you can't have anyone, it's like a year or something, right?
Yeah, something ridiculous. Or and if they bust your ass, they're taking your license or something until you're 18. Kind of weird shit. I'm like, whoa.
They have these fucking, all these reports and data that says basically like, every teenager that gets killed in a car crash, 90% of them had a friend in the car.
Yeah, distracted.
And they're like,
some kind of shit.
Yeah. And so it's, you know, it does suck, but I know they're just trying to keep everybody safe, I guess.
Yeah, you know, and then this is where I use my point where I'm like, you know, the self-driving cars, and people are like, I would never trust that. Like, trust the I know Chip has heard did some dumbass shit in a car.
Seriously,
I said so. I would trust a AI version over Chip and CERN 16.
Oh yeah,
bobbing down the freeway at 140 miles an hour in the Toyota Corolla Sport.
Did have a spoiler on it, CERN. What's the statute of limitations on that kind of thing? And then the worst thing was when we had the rental car.
Oh, yes.
Then it was like, then we really didn't give a fuck about the it because it wasn't even ours. Yeah. And it was kind of a sportier one, too. So that was a problem. Yes. Which I don't know how they would have given that to an 18-year-old or however old I was at that time.
Yeah,
seems foolish.
Supposedly found the dog park that was being built. You remember that?
On the Mahaney one?
Yeah. Remember, it wasn't built yet. They were kind of laying it out. This is when we were in our Brody session.
Yeah. We were really into spinning donuts in Brody's places.
Yeah.
So we may have fucked this area up near our house. Or near one of our houses. Stone's
throw away from where we were. Just...
Totally. Totally. Well, and then, you know, I mean, there's a real possibility that my daughter, she will be 16 in 11 years, that she might not actually really have to drive because the car.
I saw this. So they said that basically maybe there's a possibility that the kids that are born or, you know, or at least new to this world at this point may not need a driver's license.
Because you'll be able to, on your phone, just be like, here's where I'm going. And the door will open. You'd be like, how's it going? The car will talk to you and stuff.
Yeah.
And you just be like, yeah, I'm going to school. And it will just fucking take you and it'll drop you off. And then it will like come back home, I guess. Or I don't know.
Yeah. Something like that. That's one philosophy I did hear.
We're here. Starting the future is now. Future is now.
So it's the present.
Yeah. Well, we're pulling again. What was our Super Bowl bet, Cerny? Chiefs. We both want the Chiefs.
Chiefs. Okay. Got us.
Okay. I would say Dana and Joe probably are going, they're probably going Bucks because they're Brady bootlickers.
Brady bootlickers. And I don't know. Was it Chiefs were favored, right?
Yeah. Oh, so then they're betting the
underdog.
Oh, Brady on the under?
Yeah. That's right. That's right. Because Dana did say that. Yeah, he's always that would he be always a lot. Beats the spread or something when he's underdog or some shit. Yeah,
anyway. Okay. Well, you know, let us know how that works out for you. We should have had him on for AMC, but we like to keep his appearances to once every 12 months or so.
He'll be back next year for the annual Super Bowl show.
Next year we'll have him back for the Super Bowl. Joe?
And Ram and Matt Stafford.
Not the Niners.
It'd be AFC teams.
Oh, yeah.
Mahomes, the Chiefs.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Well, also, coronavirus cases are way down, so you know what that means. People are wearing their masks, they're social distancing, scrubbing those pussies, scrubbing those balls and penises and shafts and helmets, assholes and all that stuff. So that's good. So let's keep going with that. Let's roll the vaccinations. Maybe we can, you know, we got someone in there who wants to make moves now. Biden's...
One thing real quick. I'm going to digress. Yeah. I was driving and I was listening to a commercial. And I was like, yeah, do your part. Wash your hands. And then I said, and your pussies, right? I got to. What the hell does that have to do with anything? That's just a...
Chip sorry. I don't know. It's just...
You clearly don't listen.
Yeah.
I got that. What the hell does that have to do with anything?
Wash your pussy.
The chip is there,
did she give
fan.
You the like the backhand thing?
I got the side-eyed stare. Oh, the side-eyed, like, what the hell are you talking about?
Probably because it was so off the wall. It like caught her.
I wasn't even thinking. It was just because, you know, we say it all the time. Yeah. So I said it. I just said, and you pussy. She's like, what the hell is that? What?
Vulgar. So vulgar.
Okay, sorry.
Anyway, until next time, I'm Chip.
I'm Cern.
Cheers. Oh, that was...